Hi, I'm Heather. I'm one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. Today in this tutorial, I'm going to talk about the device tree. It's one of the main structures that you're going to use in our web interface, and you're always going to be in there navigating as you drill down through your probes, devices, and sensors. So I'd like to help you get familiar with it. Let's get started looking at the device tree right now. So everything we do in PRTG is through the device tree. It's a big hierarchy. So it starts with root because it's the top of your tree, simply. Underneath root is the probe level. In PRTG, the probe is the piece that does the polling out to your devices over various protocols, SNMP, WMI, flow ping, whichever protocol you're using to grab the data and pull it back. So when you first install PRTG, you're gonna see the local probe because it's on your PRTG server. Some installations, you just have a local probe, but if not, others have what we call remote probes that you see in my environment underneath the local probe. A remote probe is a probe that's remote, exactly that. So you just have a piece of software you install on a Windows machine at another location, network segment, or even at the same location, but you may want to load balance a little bit, you're polling. So you install the remote probe, take care of it in this GUI interface here. So after root, we have probe level. And I'm going to use my data center probe for everything else because that has the most interesting stuff in here to show you. Underneath every probe, whether it's the local or the remote, you're going to see a probe device. That's actually the device where your remote probe is. And normally you're going to always have your system health, probe health, sensors to keep an eye on the health of it. Then of course you can add other sensors if you want to take care of it, like your disk or memory, ping, and so on. So after the probe level though, you're gonna see groups in PRTG. Groups are for your own organization. And during your initial auto discovery, when you first install PRTG, PRTG will make some group structure up for you. You may see that now. You can change it. It's anything you want it to be. So here you could see I organize there's groups by type, network, power, environment. Maybe you wanna do it by staff if different people in your team take care of different devices. That's a way to do it. Or if you don't use remote probes and you have a few other locations, your local probe monitors, you may make location type groups. Also, groups, if you get granular on permissions on who's accessing parts of PRTG, groups helps with that and granular notifications. So think of your group structure. The best part is it's fluid. So you could change groups at any times and all your devices and data follows that. So now as we go through the groups, and they can be nested, you can see here we have different nested groups in PRTG. Eventually you're going to get down, and in groups you're going to have a device eventually in PRTG. So how do we represent a device? It's simply an IP address or a DNS name. So I'm at my device, the friendly name is traffic, you name it whatever you want. And then here you get your IP address or DNS name. And also when you put a device in the device tree, you can change the icon. We have some vendor specific, we have some generic ones, you can do that there. Then underneath the device level, we have sensors. To us, a sensor is one aspect of a device that you want to monitor. It's the life and breath of PRTG. It's everything we do is based around sensors. Your devices, unless you're just checking ping and up down, will have multiple sensors. So here, speaking of ping, is my ping sensor. That's how you're going to know if something's up or down. And you can see we have channels. Channels are the metrics about the sensor, and that's where you're going to actually get your data. So ping, it's ping. We have 5 sensors. So let's take a look in another sensor I have in here in my switch. I'm going to go in this guy. And here, this one has 4. We have traffic in, traffic out, and traffic total, because it's an SNMP traffic sensor. And for some sensors, you can come in too and turn additional channels on if it's available. But as another example, since we're in the device tree, let's pop into another sensor just so you could see in comparison something a little bit different. What shall I choose? I'll pick this traffic sensor here. And of course, I pick one that has 4 channels as well. That's my luck here when I'm recording a video, right? So I know one that's going to have a lot. We're going to just take a look at, let's switch it up a little bit, a VMware host performance sensor. So instead of looking at just your traffic in, traffic out, and traffic total, here's a sensor with more channels. Sometimes we get sensors with up to 50 channels, it's depending. So that's the basics of the device tree from root through sensor. Now, just so you know, what else you can do with the device tree is that's how we credential. Anything you set at root flows down through the whole tree. So if I click on my settings button here, that's where you're going to get to set, or you're going to want to leave, you have your group name, but this is root, so don't move that, or I wouldn't rename that. Some people do. I like to keep it at root. Your location. So if your groups are different locations or probes, you can update that and use that for GeoMaps. Credentials for Windows systems, which we do recommend domain admin credentials if possible. And then you can go with your Linux, Linux, Mac OS, your VMware Zen server, SNMP, and so on. And a few other settings in here that you might set throughout the device tree are scanning interval, your schedules, dependencies, and maintenance window, access rights, because I did mention earlier, different groups you might want to get granular with your permissions, and the channel unit configuration, because you might want to bump it up from kilobits to megabits. So right now here, I'm at root, but just to give you an example, if you go into the groups or the probes, I can pick my Citrix group here, for example. I hit my settings tab, so then everything now I set at this level, it can go down. I can turn off the inheritance for my, well, it's Citrix, so I don't want to use my Windows settings, but say if I want to come down here and my scanning interval, I stop inheritance and I could set what I want for that group right there. So that's where the settings tab comes into play. The other thing that you're going to play around in the device tree is the notification triggers tab. I can't talk right now, I've been talking all day. So if I come in here and I want to go into, again, I'm picking, oh, something went wrong, we get to all snap. All right, it reloaded. It's a browser. Browsers do that sometimes. But your notification triggers tab here, I could set my notifications. So if I want to define at a particular group, I can, or I can inherit it from above. I'm not going to spend a lot of time or any more time really on notifications because I have another tutorial that goes into that in details, but I wanted you to see where that is in relevance to the device tree. If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.